begins a paragraph. You have to start finding people and donate money to charity, I think. Part of the statement begins in paragraph 4.2.4 by recording that Horton, Sefton and St Helens have raised concerns at a much, much earlier stage of the process about the delivery of strategic BAs, so warehousing uses, within the Liverpool city region, and their concerns that local plans for Liverpool, Horton and St Helens have been examined and no regional approach has yet been agreed. That was the point that was raised. We discussed all of that with the city region, and the outcome of all of that is that at 4.2.7, you see, through engagement with the relevant authorities, it's been agreed that this is a matter which should be addressed at a regional level, and Wirral Council will seek further consideration of this by the combined authority, the Liverpool City Region combined authority, through their emerging Liverpool City Region spatial development strategy. So, in other words, the outcome of the cooperation is the point that we've raised. The outcome of all that is it's been agreed amongst all relevant duty to cooperate bodies, say relevant those who are interested in this subject, it's been agreed between relevant duty to cooperate authority bodies that this issue is to be addressed through a Liverpool City Region scale spatial development strategy. And that's the outcome. So we've cooperated with them. Those across the room, sitting diagonally to my right, might not be content, probably aren't content with that answer, but that, you know, that outcome. That is the outcome. So have we cooperated? Yes, we have. Did authorities, three authorities at early stage of the process, put this on the list of the things they want to discuss? Yes, they did. At an early stage, were they concerned? Yes, they were. What did that process of cooperation result in? Would it result in an agreement? This is not a matter the Wirral local plan can address and take upon itself. This is a matter for the Liverpool City Region to address through a spatial development strategy. That's the outcome. So we have cooperated, as long as if we've omitted this subject. And did you want to add anything to that? Yes, Mr. Cummins wants to add my point. Mr. Vital Points, so I'll go to my right.
Thank you very much. No, you haven't missed out the vital point, but just to add to that, really, following on from that agreement, work is underway by ICNI to produce a housing and economic needs assessment, otherwise known as a HEDNA, which will inform or is informing the spatial development strategy for the city region. This work would include a specific forecasting exercise for BA warehousing units. Large-scale BA warehousing units. So this has been undertaken, that particular exercise has been undertaken by MGS Transmodal alongside ICNI, and will be set out in a separate paper in due course. So the Council is very much of the view that is the appropriate mechanism for determining the future need for strategic BA development across the city region. And obviously that's what our duty to cooperate process has found and agreed as well with Brighton Partners.
Thank you. So I suppose if they're in terms of duty to cooperate, we're not dealing with duty to cooperate. There's a question then that I've got, which isn't duty to cooperate, but I'm asking that, but you'll probably come into some of the things I'm writing. That study then would be too late for the rural local plan.
You're examining Wirral local plan now. And so yes, I mean, that study, as I understand it, it will feed into another development plan document, that's to say a special development strategy for the city region. And as this is a regional, sub-regional scale issue, on the face of it, it would seem to be a sensible outcome for that issue to be addressed in that way. But whether it's a sensible outcome or not a sensible outcome, there's a duty to cooperate point. You know, the point was raised, it's been discussed. As it happens, the relevant parties have agreed an answer to the point. But even if they haven't agreed, we're still cooperating, we're still discussing this point. As it happens, an agreed outcome has been reached. So there's no duty to cooperate point. So maybe
does not have a duty of operating space at this point. Can you explain why?
Thank you, sir. I'll try to be brief, but picking up on various points that have been made so far. So I don't think there's been any a point made that a strategic employment land is not a strategic point, as I've kind of my right road having that conversation with the council about whether or not the point they're making was strategic. I think it's accepted that employment needs are a strategic issue. And using the definition that the council were quite clear about, in terms of it covering at least two planning areas, we've got those duties to cooperate performers within Appendix 8 to SGD 1.1. So Appendix 8 lists those duties to cooperate performers from each of the neighbouring local authorities. And within those, as neighbouring local authorities, covering therefore more than one planning area. It lists their strategic cross-boundary matters, the second one down in each performer is planning for employment needs. So I think we're on equal footing that employment needs are a strategic matter. In addition to that, we raised the concern specifically that large-scale strategic B8 needs were not being addressed through this local plan. We consider that to be a strategic matter, and we also consider it to be a matter for Wirral as well in itself. Within our statements for this session and for later, and within our Regulation 19 representations, we evidence this being a strategic need by way of one particular occupier, which we have tried since early 2020 to bring to the borough of Wirral. So we identified and met with the local authority and raised with them that a particular occupier was looking to move into the Wirral, had a requirement of strategic scale. So they required just over a million square feet of floor space. That was for a paper manufacturing company. That's referenced in our Regulation 19 reps, so I'll try and jump through the points quickly. But their needs could not be accommodated. We were having these meetings with the council over Teams because of COVID times back in 2020. But we had those discussions with the council and asked them at that stage, with the immersion plan as it was in early 2020, was there a site that could accommodate that level of investment? It was 125 million euros, 500 new jobs being brought into the Wirral. We had an occupier waiting for a piece of land. And the council officers were quite clear they did not have a site that could meet that strategic need. At that point in time, sir, it wasn't produced. The SGD 1.1, which I'm referring to, was available in October 22. So at that point in time, I didn't have access to all of the detailed notes that sit in Appendix 8, where it details each of the and we're in the subsequent meetings that were held between the local authorities and the council, so I didn't know whether or not that matter was being discussed amongst those local authorities. So the fact that we were bringing in an occupier that couldn't be accommodated, knowing that there was a need for strategic BA uses because it was in the Shalma. Sorry, am I right? I get you, Sam. In the Shalma, the strategic housing employment landmark. Anyway, sorry, LCR law is the document reference.
Thank you.
Those documents weren't available to me to be able to know the extent to whether the points we were raising were being effectively and communicated with those in authorities. So the fact that we're looking at accommodate that unit, were they having those discussions in Hammond, were they having it with Holton, were they having it with Cheshire and Cheshire West? We didn't know. Since these documents have been published, I've been through all of the appendices, SGD 1.1, and nowhere, not once, is the Stoford requirement referenced as a strategic issue within those meetings. And as a clear market signal, which we know is in the framework, as the council needs to take account of the repairing plan, that has not been taken account of. It has not been carried forward in this document. And it led us to the point where we actually sat with the council, again over Teams, and the occupier to give it further gravitas and say, well, actually, this is a real life requirement that needs to be employed. The council simply put it out there, we can't alter a plan, we can't accommodate you, you're going to need to submit to various social services application. And that isn't plan making, given that requirement's been known about for 3 years. I'll stop.